His works flow out of union with him. John 14, verse 20. At that day you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. As Jesus continued to talk to his disciples, right after he had given them this amazing statement that those who believed in him, the works he did, they will do, and even greater works than those because he went to the Father. Jesus went on to say that at that day, that is post his resurrection and ascension, you will know, there's a revelation that's going to be given to the people of God, to his disciples. You will know that I am in the Father, that you are in me, and I am in you. So what's he talking about? He's talking about a place of spiritual union, something the Old Testament saints did not experience. Paul writes in 1 Corinthians 6 and verse 17, he says, he who is joined to the Lord is spiritually one with him. Jesus said, I am the vine, you are the branches. Talking about a spiritual connection that we have with him. That's what he's referring to here. He says, you will know that you are in me and I am in you. There is a spiritual union that's there. Putting this in context, what he's saying is, out of this union, you are in me, I am in you, you're going to be able to do the works I did and greater works because I've gone to the Father. He says, I am in the Father. The Father is in me. There's a union between Jesus and the Father. The similar way he says, you are in me, I am in you. And because of that union, you're going to do the works Jesus did. You know, this is important for us to understand as we desire to do the works he did and greater works, to understand that you are in him and he is in you. There is this amazing spiritual union that you have with Jesus as a believer. Now, of course, in the natural, you know, we all have our natural bodies and minds, but in the spirit, we are connected to Jesus Christ. And so he, through that union, is going to manifest himself through us. So you need to see yourself as an extension of Christ himself here on earth, so to speak. That when you lay hands, it's Christ in you laying hands on the person. That when you're ministering to that person, it's Christ in you. You are in him, he is in you. Christ in you is ministering to that person. When you are casting out demons, you are in him, he is in you, and Christ in you is driving those demons out. So it's not like you are trying to do this by your own strength, by the virtue of your own power or holiness or achievements. It's simply out of this union that you have with Jesus. You are in him. He is in you. All that he is going to be expressed through you. And so you are moving with confidence, with boldness, with authority as you minister to people, expecting to do the works he did and greater works because he's gone to the Father. Understand this amazing spiritual union you have with Jesus, and understand that as you minister to people, expecting to do the miraculous, you are in him, he is in you. And out of this union, he works through you. Just like Jesus said, I'm in the Father, and the Father who dwells in me, he does the works. You and I can say, I'm in Jesus, and Jesus who is in me, he does the works. Let's pray. Dear Lord, help us to understand the union we have with you, that we are in you, you are in us, and that Christ who dwells in us, he does the works through us. Help us, Lord. Increase our expectation and let mighty works take place. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.